Chapter 1. Nobody knows this except you and I, and I'm only telling you if you promise to wash behind your ears every night for the next week. You promise? Right. Here goes. This is a story about a tiny little man who nobody but me has ever seen. His name is Chilly Billy, and he lives inside your fridge. You don't believe me? Well, here's a way you can tell it's true for yourself. Tomorrow night, just before you go to bed, creep into the kitchen very, very quietly. Go up to the fridge and don't make a sound. I usually hold my breath as I do this, and maybe you should too. Now comes the difficult part. Pretend as hard as you can that you're going to walk right past the fridge. Then, just when you think you really are going to walk past, turn around all of a sudden at the very last second, as quick as you can, and open the fridge door. What do you see? A light. There's a light on inside the fridge. You didn't turn it on because you were pretending to walk past. I didn't turn it on because I wasn't there. Chilly Billy turned it on. He always hears you coming, and he always switches the light on just in time. Then, when you close the door, he switches it off. But that's not all he does. Chilly Billy is probably the busiest little man in the entire world. But before I tell you about some of his adventures, I think you should say hello to him and see what he looks like. The picture shows him much, much bigger than he really is. That's because it's only when Billy is magnified several times that you see what an extraordinary little fellow he is. First of all, take a look at his ears. Very remarkable, those ears are. They can hear you coming a long, long way away, and that gives him time to climb down from his favorite seat on the milk bottle and turn the light on as you open the door. His ears are so amazingly good at hearing things that he can sometimes hear what you're going to say even before you say it. So you must remember not to make fun of him, because he'll hear. And he'll get cross. And he'll let the ice cream melt, or knock over your chocolate drink, or stamp around in the butter. And believe me, when Chilly Billy stamps on something, it really gets stamped on. Because, as you can see, he wears enormous boots for such a little person. You won't find boots like that anywhere outside a fridge. And the magic thing about them is that they can actually walk up walls, over lemonade bottles, and across giant ice cubes without a single slip. Not only that, they even let Chilly Billy walk upside down, hanging from the ceiling. How this happens is another secret, but as you're being good, I'll tell you. Take an extra careful look at this picture of the soles of his very big boots. See? Hundreds and hundreds of sucker pads. That's how Chilly Billy can walk up walls and along ceilings and over ice cubes. It's really a mixture of walking and sucking, I suppose. So what he does is walks. I think that's enough for now. So what we'll do now that you've met Chilly Billy is you go and do whatever you have to do next, and I'll get another story ready. Chapter 2. I promised I'd tell you how it was that I first met Chilly Billy. It was like this. Very late one night, when everybody else was fast asleep, I woke up. My stomach was whispering to the rest of me about some chocolate ice cream that was down in the fridge. Now, I know that when this kind of thing happens, it's no use trying to get back to sleep again. My stomach won't take no for an answer. So, very sleepy, I got out of bed and went down to the kitchen. And because I was in my bare feet, I didn't make any noise at all. You've never heard anything as quiet as me in my bare feet. The kitchen was really dark, that thick, black, middle-of-the-night kind of darkness. But I didn't switch the light on. I knew the light in the fridge would be enough for me to find the ice cream. I opened the fridge door. Blackness. Not a glimmer of light. That's odd, I thought. I'm sure the light was working before I went to bed. I was just going to switch on the kitchen light when I heard a strange small noise. It seemed to be coming from the freezer compartment. I put my ear next to the ice cube tray and listened very hard. There it was again, a muffled, fluttery kind of puffing with a whiffle at the end. Flutter, puff, whiffle. Flutter, puff, whiffle. That's exactly what it sounded like. And then I suddenly realized what I was listening to. It was the smallest snore I'd ever heard. Something was sleeping in my fridge. This was serious. Maybe my ice cream had been raided by a mouse who mistook it for cold cheese in the dark. Flutter, puff, whiffle, went the noise again. Keeping as quiet as I could, I crept away and got my torch. I'll surprise whatever it is, I thought. And if it's been eating my ice cream...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.